Respected Ambassador, Principals of Indian Schools in Bahrain, Sanskrit teachers, and dear students, good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
On behalf of Embassy of India, I welcome you all to the virtual launch of the Sanskrit learning app, Little Guru. Little Guru is the world's first gamified Sanskrit learning app, which has been launched by the Indian Council for Cultural Relations, New Delhi, on 9th April 2021. Before we begin the formal ceremony of launching of the app, let's watch a short animation video on Little Guru.
Namaskaraha, Mam Naam Little Guru. I spoke in Sanskrit, but I'm sure it wasn't too hard to understand. The Sanskrit language is part of a rich Indian culture, a language that is 5,000 years old. Ever thought of learning Sanskrit, but didn't do so as learning a new language could be quite cumbersome and boring considering traditional methods of learning? Ah, forget about these books here. You don't have to read them to learn Sanskrit. Well, I'm here to replace the usual language learning style with one that is more fun and easier. Taking the edutainment route via gamification, learning the Sanskrit language is now engaging and motivating. It not only helps develop language skills faster, but also boosts your retention ability. Every milestone you reach awaits rewards for you. Enjoy and enhance your learning experience by interacting with the Sanskrit community across the globe. How is all of this possible? The world's first gamified Sanskrit learning app is ready for you. Download and subscribe Little Guru app today.
May I now request Ambassador of India, His Excellency Mr. Piyush Srivastava, to kindly deliver his introductory address. Sir.
Thank you, Norbu. Good evening, good afternoon to all of you. Namaskar. The principals of CBSC schools in Bahrain, Sanskrit teachers and students, other teachers, students, and those joining this program on virtual mode. It's good to be among you after a little long time. And I remember last time when we met with all of you, there were very stressful times of the CBSC exams, and at least for 10th, decision was taken, and 12th also is in progress. So I am sure that we'll soon hear the final decision, and which will, I think, the Government of India is trying to ensure will be for the benefit of all the students and teachers. So we await that. Meanwhile, this program is the Sanskrit app. Sanskrit, as you know, is the ancient language of India, originated in Vedic period, thousands of years before the Common Era. It's a language that has potential to open doors of knowledge and heritage of Indian culture to all. Its grammatical structure is highly evolved and is seen by many as the most perfectly programmable computer language. Many of the languages of India, which also hold great literary treasure, derive a large part of their vocabulary and grammar from Sanskrit. Sanskrit, to a large extent, symbolizes an important aspect of our cultural heritage and traditions. Non-resident Indians, our diaspora, and foreign nationals can also benefit from understanding India's rich culture and ethos by learning Sanskrit language and thus engaging more with India. Indian Council for Cultural Relations has collaborated with Game App Sports with Technologies to develop this app, Little Guru. This is the world's first gamified Sanskrit learning app. The unique feature of Little Guru is that it uses gaming techniques and will cater to all age groups. As you have seen a small presentation which must have given you a glimpse of what this app is all about. Little Guru is the first tech-enabled gamified Sanskrit learning app available in the market. It is extremely user-friendly and for all ages and for people at any level of understanding of Sanskrit. Little Guru app has different levels of learning. As you have seen, they have shown the four stages, starting from learning alphabets to reading ancient texts. It provides with a path to learn, which is customized as per user's goal and current understanding of Sanskrit. It also tracks one's efforts and performance and analyzes how this can be improved upon. So Indian Council of Cultural Relations with this technological company has come up with a app which actually makes it easier for our younger children and others who are interested in learning Sanskrit language to learn it in a fashion that is not very stressful and it's enjoyable. And I am also happy to note that this important app is being launched this year when we have started commence the celebrations of India at 75 to commemorate 75 years of progressive India and glorious history of its people, culture and its achievement. I am sure that all of you, particularly the students, would find this app very friendly and useful. And this will also encourage you to learn our ancient language, Sanskrit. I am confident that our friends in Bahrain would also find this app useful, with whom we have deep-rooted civilizational and cultural connect. I thank you all for participating in this event. I think there are a demonstration is there, and I also look forward to learning, listening to some of our younger students who are participating. And at some point of time, I must admit that when I was learning, say in class 7, 8 or sometimes, I used to speak a little bit of Sanskrit. So I very much look forward to hearing some of the Sanskrit words from all of you. But before I leave, I must say, stay safe, stay healthy, follow all COVID protocols and guidelines of the kingdom. This is very, very important in the present time when the kingdom is actually making all out efforts to ensure safety and security of its citizens as well as residents alike. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
The ICSER has been promoting Indian languages, especially Sanskrit, through its academic activities. On the occasion of launching the Little Guru app, we have a video message by Mr. Dinesh Patnaik, Director General of ICSER. Let's watch the video.
Namaskar. I welcome you all to the launch of the first ever gamified Sanskrit learning app. Now, many of people ask me, why do we need to learn Sanskrit? And for all the educated listeners of today's event, I don't have to explain why we need to learn Sanskrit. Sanskrit was known as the language of the gods. The first written word in the world was in Sanskrit, in the Rig Vedas. But more than that, Sanskrit held the keys to most of the religious texts of many of the religions of the world. Hinduism, naturally, everything was in Sanskrit. Buddhism, most of the texts, the chants, was in Sanskrit. Jainism, Sikhism, many of the religions of the world, their religious texts were in Sanskrit. More than just the religious texts, many of the languages of the world, in fact, many of the languages in India, whether it is Bengali, whether it's Gujarati, Marathi, Tamil, many of the languages use Sanskrit as a base for creating the language. So Sanskrit was important in that sense, but just not the text. Sanskrit held the key to the philosophies in these religions, the philosophy of Hinduism, the philosophy of Buddhism, the philosophy of Jainism. It held the key to the philosophies and the key to some of the greatest literary treasures of the world, the Vedas, the Upanishads, the great epics like Ramayana and Mahabharata. All these could be opened and were written originally in Sanskrit. So learning Sanskrit gives us an opening, a door into these great literary treasures. But not only that, they were relevant in today's world also. In the 80s, NASA did a study on all languages of the world to see which language could be used for doing computer language, which was the most computerable language. And they realized that given its clear grammatical structure, its very strict pronunciations, that Sanskrit was the most computerable language in the world. Not only that, Sanskrit was also a language which had a structure which could merge into any computable system. And so Sanskrit was a language which was not only of the ancient text, but of modern day times also. However, it was difficult to learn Sanskrit. Unlike Latin, which went out of fashion or which people stopped using, Sanskrit is still a living language, taught in many parts of India and across the world, whether in the Buddhist countries, whether in India, in the West, everywhere. Sanskrit is still a language being taught everywhere, but taught in a manner which was slightly old-fashioned, which was in a manner which took to texts, books, and to religious teachings. What we started getting all from all over the world was request from many people in assistance in learning Sanskrit. We got requests for books, we got requests for text material, we got requests for computers, for hardware, for teachers. ICCR used to depute a large number of teachers across the world to different institutes to teach Sanskrit. And so we realized that we need something which is more modern, which is up to date, which works with technology to bring this ancient language to the people. There are a lot of people who want to learn Sanskrit, but they do not want to go through the rigor of learning it in the way it has been taught over the years. So we decided to use modern day tools like machine learning, artificial intelligence, and gaming techniques. Gaming techniques help in bringing life to the language because it makes it interactive. It keeps the attention span of the people. In today's age, young people have a very short attention span, but gaming techniques help to keep that attention span. It also helps in keeping them occupied, in going from level to level, in competing with their peers, with competing with others, in learning against themselves, in seeing that tomorrow I will learn more than what I learned today, in getting points. In the whole gaming technique helps in creating an environment where learning becomes fun. So we decided to do a fun way, an easy way to learn Sanskrit. And so ICCR teamed up with Game App Company to work out, to design this new app that we are learning called Little Guru. The Little Guru is a beautiful symbol of what we propose to do in teaching Sanskrit to people across the world. This app would help students, teachers, monks, people who are already learning Sanskrit and people who want to learn Sanskrit, to be able to get an app which will help them learn it easier at their own pace, whatever time they want, whichever location they're in, whichever area they are staying, to be able to learn Sanskrit. And at each step, it helps you do better. It not only teaches you vocabulary, it teaches you grammar, it teaches you structure, but it also helps you revise, learn, progress on a daily basis, and to find what your progress is against your peers, to get rewards, get points, complete sentences when you complete sets, when you complete courses, and also to have competitions among peers, among friends, among schools, among colleges, to be able to see how well you can progress in Sanskrit. This app, I'm hopeful, will ensure that Sanskrit becomes a language that everybody learns, which everybody practices, and it becomes a feeder into some of the great universities which are teaching Sanskrit today. Today, there is a large amount of requirement of young people to learn Sanskrit so that our ancient texts, our ancient history, our culture, our tradition does not go waste. We need this language to be able to keep our young people interested in our ancient history and culture and heritage. And so this app is something which ICCI has bought for nations of the world, for different religions, to be able to use this app to teach the young people, the youth, about Sanskrit, and through that help them appreciate the great historical, literary, and cultural traditions of the country. And I'm sure that all of you will enjoy this app. We are putting a feedback loop into the usage of the app. Your feedback, your views, your comments will help us make the app better so that it suits your requirements. Please get back to us with feedback and comments. Tell us how the app is working. The first few lessons in the app are free. After that, it is a pay-for app. But ICCR has negotiated very favorable rates, very cheap rates for using this app. And I'm sure the thousands of people who are watching this will want to use this app to be able to learn Sanskrit and to be able to open the doors to some of the greatest literary and religious texts of the world. Thank you very much. Enjoy the day. The launch of the app is from today. We will continue this launch for quite some time. We will make sure that all of you understand all the intricacies of the app. If there is anything that you need from us, you can write to us. All the details are available. It will be on our website. There's a Little Guru website also. So please reach out. Please give us your feedback, your comments, and use the app to learn Sanskrit. Hopefully next time we meet, because I'm also started using the app to learn Sanskrit. Next time we meet or next time we talk to each other, we will talk in Sanskrit. Thank you very much and namaskar.
Thank you for watching the video message by AGICCR. May I now request our ambassador to kindly unveil the Little Guru app. Thank you, sir. Now let's watch the demo of the app.
So here we are showing the website, the web app. Obviously, it's also available in Android and iOS. So you can actually use it as a web app, or you can use it on your mobile by downloading it. So various functions. The approach we've taken is how to make sure that people can listen, speak, understand, translate, eventually, you know, write, read, and eventually translate. So taking a classical approach to learning a language, not going so much by curriculum, but taking an approach where people learn to understand the words first, the pronunciation, and then eventually go on to read and write. Some very interesting features we have in the app shows us the path of learning. So if you go on that, so how do we become a Sanskrit scholar in 2021? So if we spend so much of time a day, we can go through level 0, level 1, level 2, level 3, level 4, and there we are. Before the year is out, we can count ourselves as a Sanskrit scholar. People who already know Sanskrit can start in the middle. They can start from level 2, they can start from level 3, or they can start from level 1. So the other features we also have is games and awards. So people, when we complete chapters, complete levels, there are certificates, there are badges, and there are membership rewards that we get. So that while we are playing it, you know, learning as if it's a game, it must have rewards. And then we have the membership where we get access to the whole content, we can reach out to the worldwide community. And there are lots of interesting rewards and contests and quizzes which can keep you engaged, including a shloka in your email every day. So let's quickly go through actually a demo of a few of the chapters. Shall we do that? See how it works. Okay, so we can go to learning. And we can see different levels, we can see chapters. We're constantly adding chapters, constantly adding formats, constantly adding questions. So when you see this a month later, you would see that a lot of new chapters have got added, a lot of new questions are added, a lot of new formats are added. So this is something which is ongoing all the time. So here we go. Okay, so let's say, guess the word. It's doctor, and can anybody guess which is the right word in Sanskrit? Chikitsaka.
Chikitsaka.
So, when we get it right, says the next question. Elder sister, so let's give a wrong answer.
Putri.
Oh, if the answer is incorrect, we can play it again or we can go to the next question. So we play it again.
Agraja.
If Agraja is right, that's the right question. toothbrush. So it's very easy because it's level one to make sure that the picture is there so people can make out the answer, but at the same time they are finding the right word and understanding the right word. Okay, so we'll step out now to maybe one of the other sections. And let's see.
Devi Gayati.
So that's the phrase. So we have to choose the right one and drag. So let's say drag Devi. And let's choose the wrong one. Gayati and say it. Okay. So that's incorrect. We can play it again. Now we can go here and this goes back and I can select this and submit it. So that's the right answer. Similarly, we can go to another chapter or we can go to another level. See some more questions. We can look at the avyay, the particles. Yeah. So it's come here. So let's say. Now it's level two, so it's getting slightly difficult. But obviously, in all this process, while people are learning, and at the end of it, chapters, they get to see the, all the questions they answered. So the vocabulary and all the words that you've gone through, whether you get it right or wrong, you get to practice all of them at the end of the chapter. Okay. So while we are doing this, the system is actually analyzing all our performance, clearly seeing how we are answering certain questions. And of course, we have level zero as well. Level zero, where we have basic, very, very basic understanding of the letters. We are also introducing Roman letters there. Right now, they are in Devanagari. And we're also introducing Roman letters there so people can understand. So you can see various choices. We are listening to the word and pick the question. Here you can listen to the letters.
Ooh.
So you can choose that. So level zero is essentially for people who are, you know, beginning to understand Sanskrit. Most of people who understand Devanagari can straight away go to level one. So while we were doing this, let's also go to analytics to see the questions that we've been answering. How is the chapter-wise progress we are making? You know, so it's good in case you actually are working with a teacher. You can see that how you're progressing, or it's self-progress. And then we can see how much we answered correctly, wrongly answered, what is the chapter progress. And then if you want to see some of the questions that we had answered, we can refer to that, which ones we got right, which ones we got wrong. And this is in the analytics, but at the end of the chapter, you would actually see the correct answers as well, wherever you got it wrong. But as if you can play again, it gives you three choices. In any case, to learn, it's at the end of the chapter, it tells you. So you can go through a revision. So fun to learn, interesting. You know, as I mentioned, my children like it. Older people also like it very much. You know, my own son, he's just finished the whole chapter in one go. Normally, he doesn't have that much of patience, but he actually went about 6-year-old. He actually finished all 20 questions and then the next 20. So essentially because it's a lot of fun. And and after that, obviously, they ask for rewards. So we have badges and, you know, various certificates which come to kids who enjoy the rewards that they've got.
Thank you for watching the demo of the Little Guru app. Now I invite Ms. Monica Sethi, principal of Alnu International School, CBSE curriculum, who is also the convener of CBSE schools in Bahrain, for her remarks, please.
A very good evening to the August gathering present here today. His Excellency, Mr. Piyush Srivastav, First Secretary, Mr. Norbu Negi, respected principals of all the CBSE schools in Bahrain, distinguished guests watching the program live, dear teachers, and of course, my dear students. Yatha Suryas Tatha Gyanam. The meaning of this very small Sanskrit shloka is that knowledge is like light, it drives away darkness. It is indeed a pleasure and an honor to be a part of this virtual launch of the Little Guru Sanskrit app today. This excellent initiative by the Indian Embassy of Bahrain, the Indian Council for Cultural Relations, in collaboration with the Game App SportsWiz Technologies to develop the world's first Sanskrit learning app is a blessing in disguise. The mission of Little Guru, to teach Sanskrit in a way so that everyone understands it, will help in understanding the language much, much better. Sanskrit and Indian culture are intertwined, as most of the ancient indigenous knowledge is available in this language. Sanskrit is one of the oldest and the most powerful languages on this earth. It is highly structured and helps a learner to improve memory and problem-solving capacities. It is one of the best pathways to Indian culture, and I want to tell all the youngsters present here today that for better understanding and immersion into Indian culture, they must surely learn this language. It helps in developing better linguistic capabilities. It reduces the ambiguity in speaking and writing, and also facilitates the study of other languages. After witnessing the virtual launch and seeing the demo of the Little Guru app, and also hearing Mr. Dinesh Patnaik, the Director General of ICCR, I am overwhelmed beyond words at the marvel that has been created. The use of latest machine learning, AI-driven technologies, and classical designs in this app have definitely made Sanskrit simple, entertaining, and fun to learn. This app, which has been created for all levels and all age groups, and for people all across the world, has the ability to empower a person, a learner, to speak with others at their own pace and level, and also interact with similar-minded people, and finally enhance their ability to learn the language. This app is definitely going to open doors for people to access the rich cultural heritage of India and also create awareness about the language worldwide. The desire of the Indian community settled in different parts of the world who wish to stay connected to their roots, as well as have access to the rich cultural epics, texts of India, has finally been fulfilled. They now have access to a platform, the Little Guru app, which will enable them to fulfill their wish to further enhance their knowledge of the language. Many people, organizations, schools, colleges, universities around the world would benefit a lot from this app. It is also going to be a great help to all who are already connected and learning Sanskrit, or those who are desirous of learning this language. This can be done with this app in an easy manner, as it has so many games, competitions, rewards, peer-to-peer interaction, which are some of the features that were seen in this app a little while ago. It also combines education with entertainment, therefore helping students advance their knowledge further of this language. And I'm sure the young learners here sitting with us are surely going to benefit. As a student of Sanskrit, you all must understand the beauty and importance of this ancient language, which is our heritage. To conclude, let me once again congratulate all stakeholders and participants who were here today for this virtual launch, and I'm sure everyone is going to benefit from it. Looking forward now to listen to our young students in Sanskrit. Thank you all once again. Stay safe, stay healthy. Namaskar.
Thank you, Ms. Sethi, for your valuable remarks. Next, I call upon Ms. Mamta Mohan, Sanskrit teacher of the Indian School, to share her views, please.
Sarvebhyo Namaha. Mama Nama Mamata Mohan. Aham Bharatiya Vidyalayasya Samskrita Vibhage Adhyapika Asmi. Adya Samskrita Bhashayaha Prathanyam Adhikritya Aham Kinchit Vaktum Icchami. Bharate Anekaha Bhashaha Santi. Tasu Bhashasu Shrestha Bhasha Bhavati Samskrita Bhasha. Prayena Sarvasu Abhibhashasu Samskrita Bhashayaha Prabhavaha Drashtum Shakyate. Esha Bhasha Prajinapi Nitya Nodani Bhavati. अस्माकं संस्कृतेः आधाराः वेदाः एतया भाषया लिखितम्। वेदेषु मनुष्याणां कर्तव्य अकर्तव्यस्य सम्यक्तया निर्धारणं वर्तते। यदि संस्कृतं न जानाति तर्हि किञ्चित् नष्टः इति मन्यते। सः वेदाः उपनिषत् रामायणं महाभारतम् आयुर्वेदः योग इत्यादीनां ग्रन्थानां सारांशं कर्तुं न शक्यते। एतासु पठनशाखायां संस्कृतज्ञानं विना शोभितुं न शक्यते। विदेशेषु अपि अस्याः भाषायाः प्रचारः वर्तते। एषा भाषा सङ्गणकेषु अपि प्रयोक्तुं शक्यते। अद्यत्वे नासा संस्कृतभाषा सङ्गणकभाषारूपेण प्रयोक्तुं चिन्तयति। भारतीयपैतृकं तालीपत्रे भूर्जपत्रे च लिखितम्। एतानि पत्राणि सङ्गणके सान्द्रमुद्रिकारूपेण द्रष्टुं शक्नुमः। एतत् गवेषकानां कृते सहायकं भवति। इस्रायेल् राज्यस्य सांस्कारिकभाषा हीब्रू, पुरा तद्भाषा मृतभाषा इति अमन्यत। अद्य तद्भाषा औद्योगिकभाषारूपेण प्रयोक्तुं शक्यते। एवं रीत्या वयमपि संस्कृतभाषायाः परिपोषणं कुर्याम। आगामि संवत्सरेषु संस्कृतस्य सामान्यभाषारूपेण द्रष्टुं शक्नुमः इति आशां कृत्वा अहं विरमामि। धन्यवादः। Here is the translation for my speech. There are many languages in India. The greatest of those languages is Sanskrit. Sanskrit is the mother of all languages. The influence of Sanskrit language can be seen in all languages. This language is ancient but modern also. The Vedas, which are the basis of our culture, are written in Sanskrit. Vedas clearly describe what man should and should not do. If someone does not know Sanskrit, then something is missing. He cannot get the essence of the books like Vedas, Upanishads, Ramayana, Mahabharata, Gita, etc. Without the knowledge of Sanskrit, one cannot excel in Ayurveda, Vedic maths, yoga, philosophy, and astrology. This language is popular in foreign countries. Sanskrit language can be used in computer. In the near future, NASA is going to use Sanskrit language as computer language. Indian heritage is written on palm leaves. These manuscripts can also be read and seen in the computer through CD. This will help the research scholars. Israel is a great example. They led a movement to revive their cultural language Hebrew, which was also considered once a dead language. Today, they made it as official language. We too must preserve our Sanskrit language. I hope that in the coming years, we will be able to see Sanskrit in the form of a common language. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Mamata Mohan, for sharing the information about Sanskrit in Sanskrit language. Thank you. Next, I would invite Master Shauryavir Singh Rathore, student of class 7 from the New Millennium School, who will recite a shalok and speak a few words on this occasion. Mr. Shauryavir.
Yes. Dharma Kshetre Kuru Kshetre Samavetayu Yutsavaha Mamaka Pandava Shaiva विमूढानानुपश्यन्ति। नमो नमः। मम नाम शौर्यवीर सिंह राठौर अस्ति। अहं न्यू मिलेनियम विद्यालयस्य छात्रः अस्मि। भाषाणां जननी संस्कृतम् इति उच्यते। अमृतवाणी, देववाणी, वेदवाणी इति अस्य अन्यानि नामानि। अस्माकं वेदः गणितम्, अर्थशास्त्रम्, राजनीतिशास्त्रम्, ज्ञानं विज्ञानं, पुराणानि संस्कृत भाषायां समुपलभ्यते। संस्कृत साहित्यम अति समृद्धं विविध ज्ञानमयं च वर्तते। संस्कृति रक्षणार्थं संस्कृत ज्ञानम आवश्यकम्। कर्नाटक राज्यस्य मट्टूर नामी ग्रामे अध्यापि जनः संस्कृत भाषायामेव वदन्ति। यतः सर्वे भवन्तु सुखिनः। भारतस्य पत्रप्रधान मोदी महोदय संस्कृत प्रियः अस्ति। तदर्थं वयं सर्वे मिलित्वा संस्कृतस्य तथा संस्कृतेः संवर्धनं कुर्मः। जयतु संस्कृतं, जयतु भारतम्। हिंदू अनुवाद। भाषाओं की जननी संस्कृत भाषा है। अमृतवाणी, देववाणी, वेदवाणी इसी भी नाम से संस्कृत की पहचान है। हमारे वेद, गणित, अर्थशास्त्रम, राजनीति शास्त्रम, पुराण संस्कृत में बंधे हुए हैं। संस्कृत साहित्य अतीव समृद्ध है। ये भाषा हमारे लिए एक मूल्यवान देन है। संस्कृत रक्षण के लिए संस्कृत का ज्ञान होना आवश्यक है। कर्नाटक राज्य में मथुर गांव में अभी भी संस्कृत भाषा बोली जाती है। वैज्ञानिक भी संस्कृत भाषा का अंतरिक्ष में संदेश भेजने वाला के लिए उपयोग करते हैं। भारत के प्रधानमंत्री भी संस्कृत प्रेमी हैं। उनके भाषण में हम संस्कृत वाक्य सुनते आ रहे हैं। इसलिए हमें भी मिलकर संस्कृत और संस्कृति का संवर्धन करना चाहिए। संस्कृत भाषा विजय हो, भारत माता की जय। धन्यवाद।
थैंक यू शौर्यवीर फॉर ब्यूटीफुल श्लोक एंड इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट संस्कृत इन संस्कृत लैंग्वेज। नेक्स्ट आई कॉल अपॉन मिस स्वाति सुरेश, स्टूडेंट ऑफ क्लास 10 फ्रॉम द इंडियन स्कूल, टू स्पीक ए फ्यू वर्ड्स।
नमस्ते। सुरस सुबोध विश्व मनोज्ञ ललिता हृदय रमणीया, अमृतवाणी संस्कृत भाषा नैव क्लिष्टा न च कठिना, नैव क्लिष्टा न च कठिना। मम नाम स्वाति सुरेश। अहं भारतीय विद्यालये दशमकक्षायां पठामि। अद्य अहं संस्कृत भाषायाः सरलताम् अधिकृत्य किञ्चित् वक्तुम् इच्छामि। संस्कृत भाषा श्रेष्ठा भाषा अस्ति। अस्मिन् भाषायां 15 स्वरवर्णाः, 33 व्यञ्जनवर्णाः च सन्ति। अभी च त्रयः लिङ्गाः त्रीणि वचनानि, सर्वनामानि, लकाराः, धातवः इत्यादीं ज्ञानेन वयं वाक्यानि रचयितुं समर्थाः भवामः। तदनन्तरं विभक्तीनाम् अभ्यासमपि कुर्मः। विभक्त्यः भाषायाः मूलमेव। यदि मातृभाषायां कार्याणि अवगच्छति तर्हि एषा भाषा सरला एव। अधुना अहं संस्कृतभाषा अनायासेन गृहीतुं शक्नोमि। अत्र काठिन्यं नास्ति, सरलता अस्ति। नैव क्लिष्टा न च कठिना। पठतु संस्कृतं, जयतु संस्कृतम्। इति उक्त्वा विरमामि। The English translation of my speech. Sanskrit is lovely, easy to understand, universally agreeable to the mind, elegant, beloved, to be enjoyed, sweet speech, not obscure and not difficult. My name is Swati Suresh and I'm studying in grade 10th of the Indian School, Bahrain. Today, I would like to say a few words on the subject. How Sanskrit is easy to learn. Sanskrit is a great language. The language has 15 vowels and 33 consonants. And there are 3 genders and 3 vajans. We can compose sentences with knowledge of pronouns, tenses and roots. After that, we have to study cases. Cases are the basis of the language. This language is simple if you understand things in the mother tongue. Today, I can easily understand Sanskrit. There is no difficulty, only simplicity. Thank you.
Thank you, Swati, for presenting the Sanskrit language in such a beautiful way. This concludes our today's program. On behalf of Embassy of India, I would like to thank all the principals, teachers, and students who actively participated in today's event. We also thank all the Sanskrit enthusiasts who have joined us live through our social media accounts. At the end, I would like to inform you that Little Guru is a subscription-based app. The Indian and Bahraini students who are interested in this app may please let us know. The embassy can facilitate in obtaining this app at very favorable rates. Thank you all. Thank you for joining us.